Hey guys, here's Chris from TapTech, and this is a comparison between the Amazon Kindle Fire HD here on left side and the Google Nexus 7 on right side. And price tag, it's pretty the same. We have $199 for the 16GB version of this tablet, of the Amazon Kindle Fire HD. Then we have $199 for the Google Nexus 7, but just with 8GB. If you want to have 16GB, you have to pay $249. And here we have another version with 32GB. For $249, so pretty same price tag here, but there are some differences. Maybe why you want to choose the more expensive version here, the Google Nexus, and if not, but you will see it in the review what are the differences and what you have to get. So first of all, in terms of performance and so on, we have here a Tegra 3 quad-core CPU, which have a better performance than the dual-core CPU from the Texas Instruments, which is clocked at 1.2 GHz. Both have RAM of 1 GB, but the OS is much better here. As you can see, it's very fluent, there are no lags and so on. What we have here, the Amazon Kindle OS, or a Kindle Fire OS with this carousel, and sometimes it will take some time. Let's go back here. Sometimes it will take some time that it's open an application or something else. So it's based on Android Ice Cream Sandwich here, but what you maybe not like here on Amazon Kindle Fire is that you have a lot of advertising what is going on here and what is deeply built into the OS. When you unlock your screen, you see an ad. Another one. Oops. Another one. So sometimes it also awakes from the sleep mode and it shows you the other advertising, and then one after the other in seconds period, so you maybe don't like that. And there is also in the OS, when you have a book, when you have installed a book like here, this one, you get related content. Customers also bought this book, you can open it, buy it. So you're always coming to the Amazon App Store or just store where you can buy content, buy books, buy movies, or other things from Amazon. So it's kind of advertising machine here on Amazon Kindle Fire HD. If you don't like that, it's better to go to the Google Nexus 7. In terms of applications, you have more options, you have much more applications in the Google Play Store than here in the Amazon App Store. Those are not from the Amazon App Store. Mostly there are games, but not high-end games like Dead Trigger or Horn or something like that. Just games like I've also made or whatever you can see here, what's contents, games, and there are also no business applications, so most of them are games. Temple Run we have Where's My Perry, and so that's the only thing what you can find here on the Amazon App Store, and maybe that will be a problem for you. You can sideload applications. That's what I've done here. Just go to your browser, open an application, and let's see where I have my applications here. And then you can install them. Not all of them are working, or not all of them are working fine. So if you want to do more than just browsing the web and yeah, maybe watch some movies or listening to music, and if you're abroad from US, it's better you get the Google Nexus 7 here. And in terms of display, that's what I want to show it here, is that you have pretty the same display quality. Let's go to the gallery, music, photos. Let's go back here and down. And here we go, let's go to that picture. Or let's take that one, whatever. So in terms of colors and display brightness, both are pretty nice here. As you can see, in terms of colors, they have the same resolution, 1280 by 800. So pretty nice on both tablets. So hopefully I could help you. If you liked the video, please like it and subscribe our YouTube channel to see more videos and also see the review of the Google Nexus 7 or the Kindle HD. Thank you for watching.